maybe like a lot of people who end up in the profession, it's quite hard to identify exactly when we thought that we wanted to be vets, but somehow it was something that was always in my mind that I wanted to do, even though I wasn't really from an agricultural or particularly an animal background.
The first time I have a record of it was when I was 4 and I wrote it down in a little book. It had questions and I wrote the answer to "What do you want to be when you grow up as vet?" Which I can remember at the time writing and thinking that vet is at least easy.
I went to the Dick Veterinary College in Edinburgh for my undergraduate training. That was 5 years. I was lucky after that to get an award from what at the time was called the Overseas Development Administration, or ODA, to go back to university, back to Edinburgh again, and do a Masters of Science course in Tropical Veterinary Medicine.
At first, I was very interested in doing exotic animals, so-called snakes, and reptiles and small furries like rabbits and hamsters, that sort of thing. But in my final year, I decided to spend some time in America. So I did veterinary neurology, and that's where my love of neurology started. And I found that although it is perceived to be a very difficult and tricky subject, it's a steep learning curve. Once you get over your initial hurdles and neuronal phobia, as some people call it, it becomes a much easier subject and has been my life passion.
Most of the research I've done in epidemiology has been particularly concerned with infections that can spread from food animals through the food chain to people. And so those are particularly things like salmonella. So we look at where is it and why is it there in our animal populations, but we also look at how does it get from those populations to cause food poisoning incidents in people.
What my research focuses on is inherited neurological disease, and particular conditions are ones that are similar to a condition called trigeminal neuralgia in humans, and also a very painful spinal cord disease called syringomyelia, and I also look into muscle diseases and also into epilepsy. These diseases can't be cured, and they can also be very difficult to diagnose. So a lot of veterinary neurologists get into inherited diseases simply because they can't treat them. They want to prevent them. And so the first impact that my research will hopefully have is that ultimately we might be able to find the genetic cause of these and therefore be able to better treat them.
I worked in Mexico for a period in the Yucatan Peninsula, where the Maya people come from, to address problems for children with protein malnutrition, where if you could keep a few chickens in your backyard and get a few eggs, or if there was a communal cow or a few pigs, you could really do a lot to substitute and improve the local diet. And so by helping the animals be better, we help them to be more productive. By helping them be more productive, we were able to help those families to give more food to their children.
I think we all share an enthusiasm for setting up a new school. That's the exciting project that we all are really proud to be part of.
Yes, partly it will be that we'll have fantastic new modern buildings. Partly it'll be we'll have a fantastic new staff who've come together at a moment of time with a shared vision. But beyond that, I think it's looking forwards and saying, well, really, we're educating the students now, helping them to see what the whole breadth of opportunity within the profession is. That's going to be really, really exciting for them.
It's really great to think, well, we have a clean slate and we have state-of-the-art facilities and how to build something really great. And I'd like to think, Theo, that in years to come we're all sitting around in our wheelchairs, that we'll be able to look back and say, oh, we were a part of that, we were there at the start.